Here I'm going to show you what reversible and irreversible processes, both compression and expansion, look like on an enthalpy-entropy diagram, and also use those diagrams to help us understand the behavior and the differences between reversible and irreversible processes. So these would be, for example, running a compressor for the compression process, or using a turbine to get work out of an expansion process. So let's look at first compression. So on an enthalpy-entropy diagram, I'm showing two constant pressure lines. These are not going to be straight lines, but on this scale, for what we're interested in, they're approximately straight. We're going to enter at a lower pressure. We're going to leave at a higher pressure. So pressure 2 is greater than pressure 1. And so if we look at the reversible process, adiabatic, that's the constant entropy process. We increase the enthalpy, which means we increase the temperature when we compress something, right? Higher enthalpy at the same entropy means a higher temperature. So we can see the work we have to do on the gas to compress it. The reversible work is the same as isentropic work. That's positive. We're adding energy to increase the pressure, and we're increasing the enthalpy. The work then, reversible, is just the final enthalpy minus the initial enthalpy. So now I want to compare this to an irreversible process, what would correspond to a real process. So here I'm showing in blue a real process. Now the entropy increases, so S2 is greater than S1. We're going to the same pressure, but notice at a constant pressure line, it means the enthalpy is higher. So enthalpy 2 for the irreversible process is greater than enthalpy 2 for the reversible process. So we're at a higher temperature, higher enthalpy, and the same pressure corresponds to a higher temperature. Now I'm showing you the work for the real process, the irreversible process. Notice that the work for the real process, the irreversible process, is greater than the work for the reversible process. We have to put in more work to get to the same pressure and therefore end up at a higher temperature for adiabatic compression that is irreversible. So temperature 2 irreversible is greater than temperature 2 reversible. Now we want to look at the same type behavior but for expansion instead of compression, namely starting at high pressure, going to low pressure. So again, we're looking at the same plot, but now our starting pressure is pressure 1. Pressure 1 is greater than pressure 2. If we expand reversibly, adiabatically, that's constant entropy, we go to a lower pressure, we go to a lower enthalpy, and therefore our final temperature is less than our initial temperature. And so we can get the work the same way from this plot. The reversible work that we get out is shown here. So work reversible, which is isentropic, is our final enthalpy minus the initial enthalpy. And this number is less than 0. Removing energy from the system as work is negative. Now, if we're going to compare that to a real process, then the entropy is going to increase. So in blue, we're showing a real process, an irreversible process. Going to the same final pressure, but now notice that S2 irreversible is greater than S2 reversible. Notice that the enthalpy is higher for the irreversible process. So H2 for the irreversible process is higher than H2 for the reversible, which means we actually get less work out of the process. Delta H is negative, so delta H irreversible absolute value is less than delta H reversible absolute value. And so we're going to end up at a higher temperature. We're at a higher enthalpy. So for example, ideal gas only depends on temperature. Higher enthalpy means a higher temperature. So we compare now the two work values. So notice that now the work for the real process, The irreversible process, and we use absolute value here, is less than the work for the reversible process. And I'm using absolute value because the work is negative. So the real process, to go to the same pressure, we end up at a higher temperature, we get less energy out of the system. So when we have expansion, we're getting less work out, absolute value. When we're doing compression irreversibly, we have to put more energy in for the irreversible process.